foundation is I always feel a sense of nurturance, a sense of caring. It feels like family when we come here. And I want to say thank you so much to Rabbi Magad, because he sets a wonderful tone. I often think I come here just for the hugs and stay for the food. Sometimes a little religion may wear off on me, I'm not sure. In a little while, we will hear from the incomparable Sid Rosenberg. We'll hear the story of Hannah. It has been going on for years and years. Hannah, of course, is the woman who is one of two wives, and she cannot bear children. And she has a rival, the other wife, who torments her all the time about her inability to have children. Finally, at some point after a lot of prayer, Hannah is able to bear a son. So why do we hear this story over and over again for so many years? What is it about this story? I believe it is timeless. I think it is symbolic. We all have torment. We all have rivals. We all have desires. If we just look around today, and we read any newspapers or the news, we just see the horrendous things on TV. We see the anti-Semitism rising. It is in France, it is in England, it is in Germany, it is in South Africa. It is all over. We like to think it's over there. It's not. I want to thank our own Anita Medeiros for helping us to see that it's right here. It's on our campuses. I was at a meeting a few weeks ago, and I heard about a story of a young child, I don't know how old he was, probably middle school, right here in our public schools. He was very lucky. He was being tormented, or as we would say in our words today, cyberbullied. Does everybody know what that means? Yeah. It's when you are tormented online, kids on Facebook say nasty things to each other, it's horrible. But he was very lucky because his mother was not shrinking violent. What do you think she did about it? She went to the police. Then she went to the principal. Then she went to the teacher. Then they had a discussion in schools. Then they went to the parents of the three or four children who were doing this tormenting. When it no longer became cool, it stopped. And this is what we have to do, and this is what I want to do with the rabbi's blessing, is to have us learn to be proactive. We cannot allow these things to creep up on us. Okay. Page one. So I will share my desires with you today. Stephen, take it easy, relax. My desire is not to have any more kids. Seriously, my womb is shut. My wish is what we all wish. We wish for a more peaceful, more secure world. And I would like every single person in this room today to really seriously consider becoming proactive, taking an action. We all share, we kibitz, we talk online, we email, but we don't go to the sources of the power. What can we do with our anxiety? So I'd like us to take a step to make a more proactive step, and I will talk more about that. Democracies, as imperfect as they are our best hope. And you all know there is really only one true democracy in the Middle East. We must work together to keep Israel secure, to keep it vibrant, and to keep it strong. Maybe three or four weeks ago, I got a call on the phone, and it was the rabbi. I didn't know what that was about. And he asked me if I would consider helping to form a committee to make us more proactive, to help us, to encourage us. And I said, sure. And then I got off the phone, and I thought, oh my God, what did I say? What did I do? What am I getting into? I have no idea. This is so huge. So I did what I normally do. I ate cookies. Serious. And then after that, I did my second favorite thing. I kvetched. You could ask Steve. I can kvetch with the best of you. But unfortunately, kvetching doesn't solve our problems. The problems are many, and they are complex. And this is a wonderful, wonderful congregation. We are well-educated. Some are very politically astute. And I think we're all pretty compassionate. So, like the joke of there being two Jews in a room and 10 opinions, in this room I can't begin to think how many opinions there would be and how many people would be verbalizing. We need the best of our brains here to work together. This is very complex. And I would like to ask you to join us this year. Either join this committee, put your name on an email, join another organization, because when we are together, we are stronger. The question is, where do we begin? It's overwhelming, and it can feel paralyzing. I wondered what simple act we could do to start with. There's just so much out there. So I started looking for models. And they're out there. Angela Merkel, the Chancellor of Germany, let's see, on September 14th, was that a week and a half ago, something like that, she stood in front of the Brandenburg Gate and she denounced anti-Semitism. She led a rally. In Greece, September 9th, the parliament voted to increase penalties for anti-Semitism, 3 years in prison, $26,000 in fines for inciting an act of discrimination against religion. And get this, punishment is meted out to those who denounce or who deny or praise the Holocaust. I don't know how many of you knew this, I just learned this. Organizations inciting racism can be barred from getting state funds. South Africa President Zuma, he just pledged to combat anti-Semitism September 19th. And as I looked online this morning, our own President Obama yesterday said, we have an unshakable alliance to Israel. And he also said the same thing. So we have leaders who are speaking out. Today I was going to say, we all have to look at Resolution 707. We have to do the same. I was going to describe this little resolution which condemns all forms of anti-Semitism. I was going to ask you all to be proactive and to just click online. I was going to say that if you can move a finger, if you can click a mouse, you can move the house. But that was so clever. But guess what happened on September 18th? Any political junkies here? Anybody know? The darn thing passed. Unanimously. So I didn't have anything to ask for. But back to Hannah for a moment. Her prayers are answered and she gives birth to a son named Samuel. And I believe the story is so timeless because Samuel is a symbol for hope. I am hopeful that we can work for a better world. And I know we can do it if we work together. Every one of us in this room can help if we just take an action. I'm very excited today to announce that under Bob Levy's leadership for Tikkun Olam, we now have another committee. And we're calling it the Israel Political Action. We want everybody to take an action. So today, when you leave this service, instead of walking straight out the door, get a little aerobic activity. Maybe walk 20 paces to the right. We have a little table out there, and it has some information on it. I'd love you to sign up for the committee if you don't want to be on the committee, and I understand that. Be on the email list. Learn what's coming up. This is not the end of all the resolutions and the laws and things that we can use your help. If Steve and I sign up, I call my Congresswoman, Anna Eshoo, and I say, put down a check mark for me. Okay, one. Put down two, one for Steve. Big deal. Two Jews said, come, please join us on this resolution. If 400 people, I don't know how many people here today, call her office or whoever your congressperson's office is, yeah, okay. Now we get Congregation Beth Dayton. You get the idea. So Anna's looking at her list and she says, well, 1,000 people called. I want to stay in office. Maybe I should take a listen. So you see how that works. I know many of you know this, but that's what I'm thinking. So what I'm saying is, come outside. Doesn't hurt to look. Doesn't cost anything. Come schmooze with us. A couple of things you can do. One, you could sign up on the email list. Join a committee. Bring your ideas. We need ideas. Take some brochures. Join an organization. There are countless organizations out there. There are excellent organizations. We are stronger when we are together. To our scholars here today, does anyone know who said, the world is not dangerous because of those who would do harm, but because of those who look at it? and would not do anything. Some of you might have seen it outside. Anybody? Somebody?
No, you know, you know.
Okay, the guy was Jewish, big bushy, bad hair days. First name Albert. Here we go. There is so much to do. We cannot agree. We will not all agree on where to begin. But let us all agree to begin somewhere. And thank you for listening. Shana Tovah.